Boats are incredibly tippy as we now have a look at that start list for the A final. Poland, Canada, ROC, USA, Ukraine, China, Canada and Spain represented. So no one country doubling up here. In fact, it is the Canadians. So Canada do too have two athletes in it. But all eyes will be on Nevin Harrison as we have a look at Dorota Borowska of Poland. She began paddling back in 2012. And here is the Canadian, Laurence Vincent-Lapointe, who was world champion in this event back in 2017, 2018. But since it's become an Olympic sport, the stakes have increased. Olesya Romensko, sixth at the World Championships in 2019, so she's on the cusp of a breakthrough performance. Keep an eye on lane three. Well, just 19 years of age, she won that World Championships when she was 17 years of age. Out of the United States, Nevin Harrison. Now, Ljudmyla Lusan of Ukraine, she was sixth in the C2. Over 200 metres back in 2019 at the World Championships. Love to get herself on the podium. Now, the real unknown quantity here. She looked magnificent in the semi-finals. And this is Lin Wei Jun of China. She began paddling in 2014. The second of the Canadians, Katie Vincent. Tall at 170-175. Her high school careers test said that she should be a professional athlete, and now she is living the dream. So, Antia Yacom of Spain will start in lane eight. And so, who is the fastest canoe paddler on the planet amongst our women? The Olympic final, for the first time in history, is set for a start. And they got a good start, a clean start, yes, very good start at the top, coming from Laurence Vincent-Lapointe of Canada, the former two-time world champion. Now we start to see Lin Wei Jun of China beginning to get into her work in lane six. She has gone out very fast, as has Nevin Harrison of the United States, the current world champion.
It's Lapointe leading the race from Nevin Harrison. It's bow to bow between the Canadian former world champion and Nevin Harrison, the 2019 world champion. Harrison just leading from Lapointe. Borowska up there. And it's the Chinese still in with a shot of a medal. Harrison leads.
It is Nevin Harrison, 19 years of age, a world champion at 17. Can she add Olympic gold to her resume? An absolute sensation of an athlete. It will be the American world champion and now Olympic champion for Nevin Harrison of the United States.
And it's the Canadian finishes in second place. Vincent Lapointe held on to that second place. Harrison can't believe it. We'll confirm third place when we get it. It's a photo finish. Romsenko was up there.
Well, we talked about the rivalry between Canada and the United States. Vincent Lapointe, well, perhaps she didn't put her finest performance on in the semi-final, but she backed it up. Silver medal for her, but it is all about this 19-year-old, just 19 years of age. A world championship and now an Olympic Games gold medal, the first ever in the C1 200 for women. So a history maker, a record breaker for the American. We are just going to confirm third for you.
Camera's focusing on Borowska there. I usually know something that we don't, the cameras, but I'm not sure she did get into third place.
And it has come up here. And it will be Ljudmyla Lusan of the Ukraine, who started in lane five, that has won the bronze medal. So a remarkable performance for her. Congratulations to the Ukraine. Outstanding. Starting in lane five, winning the bronze medal. She was sixth in 2019 in the C2. She transfers that now into a medal at the Olympic Games in an individual boat. Bronze medal goes the way of Ukraine, Canada. Be incredibly proud of Laurence Vincent-Lapointe. a two-time world champion, now an Olympic Games silver medal. But it is young Nevin Harrison who is setting the standard that everybody is going to have to try and reach over the next 3 years as we head to the next Olympic Games in Paris. Simply remarkable.
It is. She wasn't quickest out the blocks. That went to Vincent-Lapointe, the Canadian, but Nevin Harrison, beautiful form and technique. Brilliant job with her coaching team that have brought her this peak of fitness. Driving for the line there. You can see her bow head. Surges back in the boat to send the bows towards the line. Shouts for joy, arm in the air, aloft.
And great scenes. It's not just about the athletes, about the coaches, it's about the family. A lot of people make sacrifices. Sport at the highest level, well, it can be incredibly selfish at times, and you need to have a good support crew around you, people who do understand. But when you have moments like this, everybody will collectively say it was well worth it. And there you go. So Olympic gold medal will go to Nevin Harrison, silver to Laurence Vincent-Lapointe, and Ljudmyla, Lusan of Ukraine with the bronze medal.
La cérémonie des vainqueurs de l'épreuve de...
And up next now, it is the women's K2 single 200 metres, the medal ceremony for the fastest canoe paddlers in the world. And a special moment for all three athletes. It was a simply remarkable final. The national anthem of the United States will ring out. 19 years of age, Nevin Harrison there in the middle. Great performance too from Laurence Vincent-Lapointe.
Yeah, and after all she's been through over the last 2 or 3 years, this will be redemption for her. Missed the competition in 2019. Back here with a vengeance in Tokyo 2020.
Les médailles seront remises par...
The medals will be presented by...
メダルの贈呈は...
Medals presented by Tricia Smith, IOC member for Canada, herself an Olympic silver medalist in rowing.
Olympian, one silver medal.
IOC.
1984 Olympic Games back in Los Angeles.
Accompanied by.
続きまして.
Mr. Narita Shoken, the ICF Executive Committee member.
ICF Executive Committee Member, Japan Olympian.
国際カヌー連盟執行役員、日本オリンピアン.
Médaille de bronze, Ukraine.
Bronze medalist, Ukraine.
So there is the Ukrainian bronze medalist. Got to be absolutely delighted having switched to canoe sprint after training in artistic gymnastics for 10 years. Maybe the balance and the poise to sit in one of these C1 canoes.
And it meant a lot to Ljudmyla Lusan, didn't it? We saw her after that race, and look, that says it right there, just how incredibly thrilled she is to get her hands on an Olympic medal.
Vincent-Lapointe, the Canadian silver medalist. She wanted to become the first female athlete to win gold in the C1 200 or the C2 500 in the Olympic Games, which comes tomorrow. Maybe she will win gold in that event with her teammate tomorrow. But for now, it's a silver medal. Well deserved.
yeah, coming, you know, 2017, 2018 world champion. Got the world at your feet, and then a young lady by the Nevin Harrison comes along, but that is just a great performance for Canada.
Gold medalist and Olympic champion, United States of America.
So Nevin Harrison, she began canoeing at the age of 12 with the Seattle Canoe and Kayak Club. First competition with the USA was at the age of 15. Became world champion at the age of 17. Now at 19, she cuddles up to that Olympic gold medal. It is a fairy story. And that's what these Olympic Games produce. A remarkable athlete, a young athlete. We'll see her again in Paris, no doubt. It'll be hard to see who can get past her.
And now the Star Spangled Banner will ring out around the Sea Forest Waterway here at Tokyo 2020. Life-changing moment, the emotion. Very few people will ever experience it. And some of you can't buy your way to, talk your way to. It knows no names. It's simply all about hard work and sacrifice. And so Nevin Harrison, the reigning world champion, and now the reigning Olympic champion. Rivals on the water, friends off the water, very much the Olympic spirit.